Good morning, students. Welcome back to this algorithm class again. In the last class, we have been discussing about finding the minimum cost in the minimum cost spanning tree of a graph using the PRIMS method. We are going to see yet another example of finding the minimum cost in a minimum cost spanning tree using the Kruskal method. Okay. Both the methods have the same purpose. Both will find the minimum cost method, the minimum cost of a spanning tree, but the way they approach the problem is different. Okay, this Kruskal method is also very simple. In this method, we sort the edges in the ascending order of their weight. Then we select the least weight, then the next least weight edge, next least weight edge, like this one by one. But when you select an edge, you should ensure that the selected edge should not form a cycle, should not form a cycle. And like that, if we proceed like that, then we will ultimately generate a minimum cost tree, a spanning tree. Then you add the weight of all the edges that are in the minimum cost spanning tree, you will get the minimum cost of that spanning tree. That is the approach that is followed in the Kruskal algorithm, and this is the algorithm for Kruskal. Okay, here the name of the algorithm is Kruskal, and E is a set of edges, and the cost is a cost matrix. N is the number of vertices, and T is a set consisting of the vertices of the spanning tree. Okay, the algorithm will proceed like this. When we go for an example, you will understand the concept behind this Kruskal algorithm. Okay, the steps in the Kruskal algorithm are as given here. Sort all the edges from the lowest weight to the highest weight. Take the edge with the lowest weight and add it to the spanning tree. If adding the edge create a cycle, then reject the edge. Keep adding an edge until we reach all the vertices. Okay. Now you may wonder, how does this Kruskal algorithm comes under the greedy method? It very much follows the greedy method, because we are given some n vertices or n edges. We are given some n edges, and we have to select edges based on some criterion function that the selected edge should minimally increase the sum of the weight acquired so far, and also it should not form a cycle. That is the criterion. What is the objective function here? The objective function is to minimally increase the sum of the weights of the edges. Sum of the weights of the edges. Okay, that is the objective function here. So this method very well comes under the greedy method. Now look at this problem here. We are given a graph. The edges are 0 to 1. 0 to 7, 1 to 6, and 1 to 2, 7 to 8, 6 to 8, 2 to 5, and 3 to 5, 4 to 5, like these various edges are given here. Now, the weights are also given here. How we are going to generate this minimum cost spanning tree? See, at the end of solving this problem, the graph generated, the minimum cost tree that is generated should be identical to the PRIMS method. The same problem we have solved in the PRIMS method also. See here, yeah, the same problem we have solved in the PRIMS method, and this was the minimum cost tree that was generated using the PRIMS method. The same tree should be generated using the Kruskal method also. Kruskal method also. Okay, let us see how does this one. Now, among these edges, which edge is having the least weight? 4, 8, 11, 8, 7, 9, 14, 10, 2, 1, 7, 2, 6, 4. The least weight edges between 7 and 6, that is weight number with weight of 1. So this edge is selected. Vertex 7, vertex 6, the edge is 1. The weight of the edge is 1. This is selected. Okay, once this is the partially constructed spanning tree, then which is the next least weight edge? After this, there is one edge between 6 and 5 with weight value of 2. There is another edge between 2 and 8 with the edge value of 2. So you can select this one or this one. That doesn't matter. So here we select the next edge between 2 and 8 with weight value of 2. Okay. So now this is the next level of the spanning tree. Then after considering this edge, the next least weight edge is, there is another edge with weight value of 2. Okay, between 6 and 5. So that is considered 6 and 5. So edge 1, edge weight 1, edge weight 2, edge weight 2. Okay, this is the next level of minimum construction. Then after these edges, which edge is having the least weight? Which edge is having the least weight? Okay, you see here 2, 2, we have 4, 8, 7, 4. Okay, the next least weight edge is 4. We can select either this one or this one. Anyone can be selected. Okay, so that's what we do it now. Okay, we select this weight edge between 1 and 0. Between 1 and 0, this edge is selected with weight value. Okay, after this, there is another edge with weight value 4. This will be selected after this. So you see here this one. Then you see here between 2 and 5, there is another edge with weight value of 4. So this is the next level of spanning tree. Then after with edge with weight value of 4, which edge is having 4? Then we have 8, 11, 8, 7, 9, 10. The next least 6, there is a between 8 and vertex 8 and 6, there is a edge 6, but this we will not select because we have considered this edge, this edge, this edge, but when I take this one edge, we will get a cycle here. So we should not select the edge between vertex 8 and 6. So we should avoid this edge. So the next least edge is between 7 and 8 and 2 and 3. Between 2 and 3. So the next least weight edge is between 2 and 3. This is selected. This is selected. Then when this is 7, see why we haven't considered this edge also? Because we have selected this one is selected. So we may not sure whether which one will be selected further. So we are avoiding this one. So this is selected. Okay. After vertex 7, after vertex, this one selecting this one, which is the next least weight edge? Next least weight edge after this 7. This should not be selected. If I select it, I will get a cycle. No. So the next least weight edge is 8. What happens when I select this edge 0 and 2? What happens when I select this 0 and 2? Zero and seven. Yeah. So the next list, this is 0 and 7. This weight is selected. That is vertex 8 is selected. That is edge 8 is selected. Okay. See. This edge is selected. Then. After this weight 8, which is the next least edge? This is the 9. Okay, what happens when I select this one? between 3 and 9, between 3 and 4, that edge 9 is selected. Okay. And you see that now all the vertices are connected with a edge, connected with an edge, and this is the spanning tree, final spanning tree that is generated using the Kruskal method. See, compare this one with the Prim's way of, okay, the same thing is generated. This is the Prim's final minimum cost spanning tree, and this is Kruskal spanning tree. Both are some. Both does the same work. Both compute the same minimum cost spanning tree for the given graph. Okay, let us see yet another example. This is the graph given, and we have to find the minimum cost spanning tree. Okay. This is, the picture is not clear. Okay. So that is the idea behind this Kruskal algorithm. Okay, we have seen how to generate a minimum cost spanning tree of a given graph. And this problem comes under greedy solution. Okay. Next, we go for the next problem, that is single source shortest path problem. What is this problem? Here also you are given a graph G. We have to find the shortest path from a given vertex to the remaining vertices of the graph. You select one vertex, find the shortest path from that vertex to the remaining vertices, and that is the single source shortest path problem. Supposing the given vertices are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then, if your source vertex is 1 means, then you find what is the shortest path from vertex 1 to 2, vertex 1 to 3, vertex 1 to 4, vertex 1 to 5, vertex 1 to 6. What is the shortest path? And that is this single source shortest path problem. Now, how does this problem comes under greedy solution? Greedy example for greedy solution. Now, here we are given n inputs in the form of vertices. And we have to find the, what is the objective? Find the shortest path from the source vertex to the remaining vertices such that the shortest distance is found out. That is the single source shortest path problem. Okay. What is the constraint here? The constraint here is the next vertex selected should not be in the already selected vertices, number one, and the next vertex selected should minimally increase the path that has been should decrease the distance or the length of the path between the source vertex and the selected vertex. That is the constraint. Okay. So this problem very well comes under the greedy solution. Okay. We can see some examples. As an illustration, look at this example. The graphs are vertices are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is a graph. And there is a edge between vertex 1 and 4 with weight values of 10 and 20, 2 and 4, 15, 4 and 5, 15, 1 and 2, 50, 1 and 3, 45, 3 and 5, 35, 3 and 5, 30, and between 6 to 5, edge value of 3. Now this is the graph. I want to find the shortest path from vertex 1 to the remaining vertices. Vertex 1 to the remaining vertices. Okay. Now you take this vertex 1. From here, there is a edge going from 1 to 2. And there is a edge going from 1 to 4 with weight value of 10. So 10 is less than 50. So from vertex 1, I select the edge to the vertex 4. So the shortest path from vertex 1 to 4 is 10. Vertex 4 is 10. Then from 4, there is a vertex 2. So there's a edge to vertex 5, 4 to 5. There is a edge with weight value of 15. You check whether there is a direct path from vertex 1 to vertex 5. No direct path. Is there any alternative path from vertex 1 to 5? No alternative path. The only path is from vertex 1 to 4, 4 to 5. When you add up, it is 10 plus 15 is equal to 25. So the length of that path is 25. You see here 25, 1, 4, 5. The path is 1, 4, 5. So it is 25. From 5, you can go to vertex 3 or vertex 2. And which is the minimum? 35 or 20? 20 is the minimum. So the next vertex selected is 2. Okay. Is there any path from vertex 1 to 2? Yes, there is a direct path. Is there any other path to vertex 2 from 1? There is a direct path. And there is another path, that is 1 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 6, but that is very lengthy one. And vertex 1 to 4, 4 to 5, then this is 20. So when you add up, already we have find the shortest path from 1 to 5. So 10, 15, 25, 25 plus 20, 45. This is which is minimum, which is less compared to the direct path from 1 to 5, 50. So the shortest path to the vertex 2 is 1, 4, 5, 2, that is 45. Vertex 45. Then from 2, you can go to the vertex 3. From 2, you can go to the vertex 3. Okay, now you find the path, there is 1 to 2, 2 to 3, that is 60. There is a direct path from 1 to 3 with weight value of 45. So with 45 is minimum, the length of the path from 1 to 3 is 45. So this is the shortest path from vertex 1 to other vertices. There is no path to the vertex 6 because no edge is going into 6, but only an edge is coming out of 6. So there is no direct path. There is no path between vertex 1 and 6. So this graph explains the single source shortest path. Okay. Now, this is the rough logic. This is the rough logic. There is a specific logic using the Dijkstra's method. And that identifies the shortest path from vertex from a given vertex to the remaining vertices in a methodological way, in a systematic way, Okay, the path is found out. Okay. Okay. So that we will see in the coming classes. Okay, it is a lengthy algorithm. We will see with an example. We will see with that the example in the coming class. Okay. See you in the next class.